I must say, I'm damn lucky you showed up when you did. Can you believe what that monster was doing? Truly. Then you're made of sterner stuff than I, friend. I'll confess, it terrified me greatly. Can you imagine dressing entirely in red? Jests aside, thank you. You forever have my humblest gratitude and a most generous discount on my wares. In the face of such horror, I don't see that I have much choice. Now, how may I help you today? A certain ineffable quality, beauty in its many forms. Very good, ma'am. Now remember, fashion's a fickle mistress, so be sure to return.
It was a ballast that tried to kill Master Figaro. I'm ever so glad Master Figaro was saved. I'd have been out of a job otherwise.
Get him right here. Printing block of metal.
He's clanking great steel.
Patched up, pushing on.
Recruits will be in the same way.
Of steel and justice.
Does he say anything about the horrible presence?
Get the right here! The printing block has never been so small.
Don't be smart with me.
One with the weave.
Truly this
door has red text on it reading, "All are awaited, all are embraced, none shall escape."
Present me well from gifts thine own, or I shall rend thy flesh from bone. A grasping hand, an offering vile. Enter now the dread lord's trial. Thou hast shown proof of worthy kill. Present thyself before Baal's will.
You gaze upon murder's progeny, child.
His most ill-trusted zealots.
His faithful departed.
Prodigal servants, each returned to do his bidding eternally.
This man is known to all Baldurians, and his presence sparks dread in the pit of your stomach. Before you is Saravok Arnchev. A Baalist who almost brought Baldur's Gate to ruin a century ago.
This is the court of the Dread Lord's Tribunal. I am its custodian. Here come those who seek to transcend. Aspirants of his most profane order. The would-be unholy assassins of Baal. A long while ago, my wretched sibling bought me back. The fairest of Baal's spawn soul-bound me to this husk. Worship death though I do, I refused it. I roamed the coast, gathering those who still held Baal in their black hearts. The cult survived, festering beneath the city, with me as the gate's everlasting poison. But no more, for poison is too slow a death. Now is the time for slaughter. With these killings, the glory of the Baalists has risen beyond what we dreamed possible during those dark days. But the worship of my lord is led by another now. My granddaughter, Arin, the youngest unholy assassin ever to follow in Baal's bloody trail, and his chosen. She is the architect of Baal's design. Baal has never had a more gifted prodigy. Arin's gift surpassed even her mother's. Her mother knew this, and she could not bear it. When Arin was but 7 years old, she tried to smother the child as an offering to our Lord. I heard the screams. I ran to help. I feared for the child's life. But the cries were not Arin's. It was her mother's blood that soaked the sheets. Arin had cut off the very hand that tried to end her, and made a plaything of it. And as she toyed with her dead mother's hand, a deep quiver rose up through her throat. The Lord of Murder speaking through the child. "Lay not a finger on this child," he said, "nor let any other, for this child will serve me with unholy ardor. Protect her in my name." I knew of my daughter's ambitions, but not the lengths to which she'd go. She hungered for Baal's favor more than anyone I'd ever known. But her daughter, Arin, hungered even more. My lord made his choice. I abided by his words. But Arin is not the subject of our judgment here today. You wish to become an unholy assassin of Baal. So, approach and be judged. Spirit of the slaughtered, return to us. Show us the truth of this murderer's intent, and let us judge her for her bloody service.
His will be done.
Herself reduced to a specter.
You took this spirit's life, and thus its voice. So, speak for it. How was this pitiable creature slain?
Reverence.
Zeal.
Long may he reign!
Your offering pleases Lord Baal. Your words delight him. You slaughter well, aspirant. You are deemed worthy. Enter the Dread Lord's abattoir and submit to his will. Stand now on the cusp of the Dread Lord's favor. One killing secures your rebirth as an unholy assassin of Baal. The slaughter of a celestial being. Make violence of its goodness. Spill its blood and bathe in Baal's eternal rapture.
Boy, I know you. Do not listen to this ancient fuck! Free me at once!
Thank you. Ars Macabre.
The blood, the night of death, it has been far too
angry. take you.
Thank you.
done.
Took you bloody long enough. You've no idea how wrinkles like mine get caught in chains like that. I suppose some thanks are in order. You did a good job putting a stop to those ballast Burks. Though I do wish you'd figured this all out before I, put the blame for Father Lorgan's murder on that poor refugee. Well, at least it's over now. After our chat at Chiaretta's Caress, I thought it best to polish off the bottle I'd started. I started coming over all woozy. My joints stiffened up quicker than a brothel browser's loins. Paralyzed. My vision went black. When I woke up, I was in chains. Overall, a terrible ordeal. One deserving of a drink. I bid you good day, but it's been royally shite all round. I most wholeheartedly agree, but you... Well, you gave these reprobates a proper seeing to. You clearly have what I don't. Courage, insight, heroism. The city needs you. I overheard these pigs talking. There's a Baal temple deep within the old Undercity that the cult is using. A century ago, it was destroyed by a group of heroic sorts. Let's hope history repeats itself, eh?
Yes, my love?
Oh, enough waiting. I crave blood.
What's next?
Cheers.